face you a little bit.
Yeah, face me a little. Actually, I'll tell you what, just so you can face out first. Guests, just before we begin, I have a few announcements. So I'm going to, it's the most unpopular announcement that I'm going to make, but I'm going to ask you to please check one more time your phone is on silent and put away. We have incredible photographers and videographers that are capturing all of today's moments that, you know, your gift of being here is the greatest gift that you can give to be fully present. The second announcement is just to wait for me to prompt you to stand during the procession and then you'll join me. And lastly, this moment has been a moment that we have all been anticipating. So wherever there is an opportunity to share love, to whistle, to clap, to cheer, please bring your full self forward into those moments so that today is as memorable as we are imagining it will be. And the ceremony begins. That's good! Practice it! Never seen him before, never heard of him. Yeah, you do it, go for it.
I don't know how.
You can take a peek, these are your littles coming out. You can look.
I can look.
She's not there yet. So it's just your little. But keep your eyes shut. Actually wait for it.
Yeah.
Wait this for this moment to happen for you.
You let me know.
You
when.
Got it.
I think.
You can just look down and just acknowledge your littles coming in here because you won't see her. Because look at how sweet these two are.
Wow. Oh my God, so look at Maddie and McKenna, my friends from Canada.
Oh my goodness, y'all look so beautiful.
So Courtney, I'm going to invite you to please turn fully to face me. And so then you'll get to be introduced to your bride coming down. Oh, you look gorgeous.
Brenda Little.
Breathe into this moment.
Get the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. That the weight has lifted.
Please turn to face your bride.
Oh man.
Guests, please join me in welcoming our bride. Guests, please be seated.
You look so beautiful, babe.
No, take it in. Dear loved ones, good afternoon. We gather here today to witness and celebrate the union of Denise Elizabeth Dewar and Courtney George Williams in marriage. My name, you can clap there. My name is the Reverend Dr. Jody Hall, and it is my honor to be officiating today's wedding ceremony. Being here today to witness the marriage between Denise and Courtney is an opportunity for us to share not only in their love and joy, but also to remember, reaffirm, and appreciate the love and friendship we experience in our own lives and the commitments that we've made within those relationships. Guests, you have traveled near and far to be here with Denise and Courtney today. You come from different chapters, different parts of their worlds, and yet what's common? Each one of you has been such an important part of how Denise and Courtney have come to give and receive love in their lives, and they are so very grateful that you have chosen to witness their ceremony. Because we learn to love from being loved, and we bring this learning forward into marriage, as marriage is not just the union of two lives or two hearts coming together, but it's the joining of families and friends, a community of support. You've come from these various pockets, both personal and professional lives, to be together. And in doing so, you are agreeing to encircle this partnership and saying, we will move forward with you as one family. Now, given the unprecedented times that we are living through, bringing all loved ones together to celebrate with us this afternoon was not possible. It is very important to Denise and Courtney to acknowledge and thank friends and family whom we know would have loved to have been here. Specifically, Courtney's family in the United States. Courtney's mother, Shirley Williams, his son Troy, and his grandchildren, Jaslyn and Jax, and their mother Candace. Courtney's daughter, Fatima, her brother Antonio, and their mother Janet. Courtney's brothers, Randolph, Garfield, and Andrew. Cousins Opal, and Mike, and Carrie Ann, and Vaughn. Auntie Noma, Auntie Lois, Auntie Maureen, and Uncle Richard. And held closely is Courtney's dad, the late Andy Williams, and his youngest brother, Sean Williams. While not physically present with us, their spiritual presence is felt deeply in the whispers of the winds as they pass through the trees that surround us, in the birds as they sing their songs, as those roosters that cluck behind us. We feel their energy radiating upward from the solid earth under our feet that provides the stability upon which we live our lives. All of these loved ones that have been noted are carried so gently in our hearts today and always, and Denise and Courtney look so forward to a time when all loved ones can gather together to celebrate. Now, before we proceed, Denise, please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare
that I do not know,
that I do not know
of any lawful impediment,
of any lawful impediment
why I Denise
may not be joined
in matrimony to Courtney. Courtney, please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare that I do not know
of any lawful impediment
why I Courtney
may not be joined
in matrimony to Denise. Guests, we gather here in extraordinary times. We are living through a moment in history that will forever be referenced for its significance and its impacts on the rhythms of everyday life. Our time spent in social isolation, physical distancing, and there have been sacrifices and struggles associated. While many of us have found these times to be challenging, also within the heart has been the invitation to pause and reflect, to express gratitude for the smallest of blessings, and to cultivate moments of deep connection with the people we love and cherish. Also, in spite of the hard, this is a moment of unbridled joy. It will punctuate through that hard, and we will all be able to recall this time that we were gathered here today. Denise and Courtney, you have found your heart's desire in one another. You have found that person within whom you recognize love most completely. It is this beautiful connection, your endurance through many of life's challenges, your resilience, and your mutual support you so unconditionally offer one another that all who gathered here are honored to celebrate with you. We all have our own love stories, our own humble beginnings, our first noticings, a shared first look, the brush of an arm, a belly full of butterflies as we anticipate seeing one another again. I'm sure that each of you who is here gathered could share their own stories of watching this story unfold. The beginning of your love story reminds me of the quote from Khalil Gibran's The Prophet, "And think not that you can direct the course of love, for love, if it finds you worthy, directs the course." Because the universe has this way of creating the circumstances where you're pointed in the direction of where you were meant to move. It is quite remarkable to consider that the person standing in front of you today was once a stranger, and now you stand here making forever commitments to one another. I just want you to take a moment. I want you to recall some of those early days and how they would have had to line up just so that one day you'd cross paths with or the profile of your person. Because despite your differences in who and how we come to love, love is what we share. It is a great unifier and a universal truth, no matter who we are, where we come from, what we believe and fight for. We know that love is what we are doing right. Love is the essence of life and how we find meaning as we live out our days on earth. As you know, when you love someone, you do not love them in exactly the same way as days go by. Therefore, what you promise today will need to be renewed tomorrow and in all your tomorrows to come. Today, you love one another generously. You use words to describe one another such as fierce, beautiful, strong, resilient, committed, loyal, brave, and I have literally pages of notes from my meetings with them because they could not finish without every sentence was a strength that they admired in one another. Their love was palpable even across a computer screen, which is how we met the first time. You were just overflowing with what one another means to the both of you and how transformative you have each been to one another. You take pleasure sharing in the simplest of joys together. However, of all the things you shared about that you enjoyed, it was about being together that you enjoyed the most. And in the time that I've gotten to know you, I have seen how you show up for one another. It's a humble and gracious, yet a very much live out loud, watch out world kind of love. It's playful, it's adventurous, it's courageous. It's the kind of love that makes you pack up your belongings and cross borders for. It's the kind of love that makes space for another to walk through their front door and instantly find their home. You've offered one another such unwavering sense of believing that anything is possible together, that you're able to dream weave quite a magical future together to make the impossible possible. Your relationship inspires. I know that you know nothing in life is perfect and that there will always be struggle. In the words of Pema Chodron, things falling apart is a kind of testing and also a kind of healing. We think that the point is to pass the test or to overcome the problem, but the truth is that things really don't get solved. They come together and they fall apart. They come together and they fall apart again. It's just like that. The healing comes from letting there be room for all of this to happen. Room for grief, for relief, for misery, and for joy. Struggle between and surrounding you has served as important reminders of your strengths, of how strong your bonds are with one another. It is so important to remember that occasional pain and moments of hardship all contribute to the inevitable and necessary personal and relational growth needed if you are to share a lifetime together. And given what you've already navigated and the challenges you have faced together, you can take comfort knowing that you will toil in that soil together, that no matter the struggle or challenge, you're rooting for the same team, you will always have your own number one fan in one another. And that's the beauty of a marriage, the shared commitment to partner in whatever life serves up. You will always be or offer one another a shoulder to lean on, a hand to hold, and a mirror to hold up to reflect to you your undeniable beauty and your inherent worthiness. I'm going to invite you to pass your bouquet mm-hmm. back, and I'm going to invite the wedding party to please take your seats. You may be seated. And I'm going to invite you to please join your hands. I'm going to invite you to look down at your hands. I know these hands are very familiar to you, that you have held them countless times. I was waiting, come on back. Beautiful. These are the hands of your best friend and now your forever partner. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you continue to build a future together. These are the hands that you reach for and find reaching back for comfort, for balance, and for reassurance of your constant presence. These are the hands that no doubt time will wrinkle and age. They will change in form and function, but may you always find them reaching out for yours with the same intention as you do so in this very moment. While today, your wedding day, is one brief day in time, and the vows you're about to make to one another will pass relatively quickly, they are the commitments you are making to one another that are meant to last your lifetime. They will reflect your unconditional love, your mutual respect, and the loyalty you have for one another. Vows are the utterances of hopes and possibilities, the most ancient part of a wedding ceremony. Through the vows you make to one another, you are professing out loud to the universe and all who gather to witness your agreement to share your strengths and responsibilities and to nurture the love that you feel as you stand before us today so that it may grow as impossible as it might seem to burn even brighter than it does today. Denise, please repeat after me. I call upon these persons. Here present. To witness that I, Denise. Do take you, Courtney. To be my lawful wedded husband. Do you, Denise, take Courtney to be your partner and friend, to love him unconditionally and without hesitation, to admire him and care for him, to make him laugh and let him cry, to offer him your best counsel and give him your sincerest support with all the love you have to give?
I do.
Courtney, please repeat after me. I call upon these persons. Here present. To witness that I, Courtney. Do take you, Denise. To be my lawful wedded wife. Do you, Courtney, take Denise to be your partner and friend? To love her unconditionally and without hesitation, to admire her and care for her, to make her laugh and let her cry, to offer her your best counsel and give her your sincere support with all the love you have to give.
Yes!
Denise and Courtney have prepared their own personal vows, which they will now read to one another. You will go first, and then I'll pass to yours, Courtney.
Courtney, you came into my life, and life came alive. I'm so present to the courage and the transformational journey your life has been. You've experienced incredible trials, and you've not only triumphed, you've emerged as the most beautiful gem. Your love for life is truly inspiring. Who you are for me is self-expression, authenticity, and passion for life. What I love about you most is the awe and childlike wonder you bring to all things in life, large and small. With you in my life, I know that magic and miracles are possible. My vow to you is that I will be there for you through all times until death do us part. I'm so grateful for your love and partnership in this wild ride called life. I love you today and always.
Love you too, baby.
You've got the best family and friends. I want them at all weddings.
Denise, you are my universe. My love for you is infinite. You came into my life and now everything matters. Who you are for me is unconditional love. You accept me for who I am and who I'm not. The life that we create is fun, adventure, laughter, and joy. My vow to you is that I will be there for you through all times until death do us part. Ride or die, baby. You are my wife, my life.
Beautiful. Take a moment, catch your breath. Good job. You can join hands again.
My wife, my life.
Yeah. My wife, my life, when I hear that, it still chokes me up. Every time I hear Courtney speak to it and explain it, it's such a beautiful love to witness, and I'm humbled by it again as I bear witness to it today. While sharing of the vows happened relatively quickly, the wedding rings are the enduring symbol of the promises you have just made to one another. Wedding rings are a visible sign of a commitment made to one another. They are a public declaration that the love shared between you is invaluable and it's something to be cherished. This is the point in a wedding ceremony where a wedding officiant will usually talk about how rings have no beginning and they have no end. But that actually isn't true. Rings do have a beginning. Rock is dug up from the earth. Metals are liquefied in a furnace at impossibly high temperatures. The hot metal is forged. It is quenched to be cooled and released from its mold. And then it is painstakingly polished. Something beautiful is made of those raw elements. And I think it's the most perfect metaphor for love. It too comes from humble beginnings made by imperfect beings with a vision in mind. So it's the process of making something beautiful and stronger together that we honor today and is represented in the exchange of rings. Also, rings do not represent two halves coming together to make a whole. They represent two complete individuals mutually agreeing to bring the best of themselves forward together in their relationship and committing to learning and growing together as a partnership in marriage. Will, you may come forward. And please just open the box up. Perfect. And if you'd like to grab Courtney's ring, perfect. Beautiful and Will, perfect. Tuck back. Just on place on the tip of Courtney's ring finger. And then wait until you pronounce and then slide it on.
Okay.
Courtney, I give you this ring.
Courtney, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
Push it, babe. Push it.
You have to do it.
Yay!
You ain't got to worry about that coming off, right?
Will, you may come forward, hon. And Courtney. Will, you can take your seat, hon. Perfect. Yes, hold for stability. Denise, I give you this ring.
Denise, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love. My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
Beautiful. Denise and Courtney, you have declared your love for each other and your hopes for the future. You have made a solemn covenant with each other to be life partners, and you have symbolized it by joining hands, exchanging vows, and now rings. May your love continue to unite you so that you may be faithful to the vows that you've made today, and may you live together in joy and peace. And so all there's left for me to do is to make it official. I, Reverend Dr. Jody Hall, by the powers vested in me by the Marriage Act, do hereby pronounce you, Denise and Courtney, to be married. And while you have kissed 1,000 times, maybe more, your first kiss as a married couple marks a new threshold that you now pass through together. As husband and wife, you may now celebrate this occasion with your first kiss as a married couple. This is another moment.
Baby, we are married, baby, we are married.
Guess we're just going to take a few minutes to sign paperwork and then we'll join you once again. So we'll follow you out. You can go through the arbor. Yep, and then back behind. You'll probably have to tuck behind the tree.
We married, baby. Yeah,
we are fucking married.
It's a little trip around. We're making a bit around front.
That's right.
Look at this impressive just underneath it, but that's okay. Go right under.
Oh,
yeah,
right
that's
here?
Okay. Yep. Perfect. Awesome. And then, yep. This way. Awesome.
Oh, you just have a look up. Everybody, have a look at me.
Awesome. And then you're going to take your time here and sign where it says spouse.
So, okay, yep, right
perfect.
Here.
Exactly. Okay. So if something were to happen to the license, this is just the backup documentation.
Okay.
That the wedding took place.
And here for me.
Yeah, you got it. So the two of you are done. So my suggestion would be for you to pick up your bouquet and just have a few moments kind of
back here.
The other side of the tree,
okay.
And just have like lavender.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah. Okay. So, we have a little bit more around it. So, whoever your son is, you will sign it. We've got a few signature lines going now.
Am I on the right side?
We're going to get there. Yes, yes, yes. And then we will welcome our newlyweds through. Perfect. And then I just have a few announcements before we close off. So immediately following the ceremony, may I please request family members to stay right where we are. All other guests, please proceed back up to the venue for cocktail hour. And guests, just a reminder that tonight is not just like any other night. It is a time for happily ever afters and forever memories, not only for Denise and Courtney, but they hope for you too. May you spend this evening celebrating the commitment of Courtney and Denise as they share their first meal as husband and wife. May you go forward with love in your heart and my warmest of regards. And on behalf of Courtney and Denise, I thank you so much for being here. It is not lost on any of us what a privilege it is to be here with celebration. So please carry that into the evening. Denise and Courtney, I hope on every wedding anniversary, as the leaves begin to change color, you recall how important it is to return to one another anew. Fall is a season of quietening, a slowing of the pace of life, and a generating of warmth to hold us through the colder times to come. It offers us an invitation to marvel at the process of letting go, to make room for new beginnings. It's all around us in the teachings of nature. It is a reminder that life is constantly in a process of growing, letting go, rebirthing, and rest to renew again. I hope your love also offers you the same invitation to grow, to let go, to rebirth, rest, and renew. May you continue to love with faithfulness, with passion, and with everything that you had. Guests, may I invite you to please stand with me. Denise and Courtney have grown in knowledge and love for one another, and because they have agreed in their desire to go forward in life together, seeking an even richer, deepening relationship and future adventures, and because they have vowed to partner in sorrow and joy as one family forevermore, please rejoice with me as I introduce you for the first time to Mr. and Mrs. Courtney and Denise Williams.
Nice to see you.